We all remember that viral video. That's 22-year-old Sophia Rosing, a former University of Kentucky student who was finally indicted for an alleged racist assault after taunting and hurling racial slurs at Kyla Spring, a black freshman at the school. Rosing was indicted on all six charges, including four counts of assault, disorderly conduct, and alcohol intoxication. The incident happened at a residence hall where witnesses captured video of Rosing calling Spring everything but a child of God. And she didn't stop once the police arrived. The arrest report claims that Rosing continued using the slurs in front of officers, resisted arrests, and kicked one of the officers and bit and hit three others, including Ms. Spring. Here's how Spring responded on CBS Mornings when she was told that Rosing is humiliated, embarrassed, and remorseful about the incident.
I say that there is an opportunity for growth in this situation. And I also say that this is an opportunity for not just her to grow and educate herself, but people who might have acted similarly or think similarly to her.
Rosing is set to be arraigned on March 17th. We want to bring in friend to the show and trial attorney, Bernarda Villalona. Now, counselor, let's first talk about the strength of Kyla Spring here. During an interview, Spring's claims that Sophia Rosing called her the N-word more than 200 times. Give us your thoughts about the tremendous restraint of Ms. Spring during this incident.
Well, she's definitely the epitome of what Michelle Obama said, when they go low, we go high, because I cannot tell you that I would have been this. I would have reacted the same way in terms of restraint, especially when we're talking about an incident that lasted about 10 minutes and when you're being called so many derogatory names and also being physically touched by another human being. She showed great restraint and great poise. I commend her for her response. Unfortunately, it's crazy that her mother had to teach her the drill, because that's how she responded. She was like, I know the drill, and I know that things could have been flipped and taken out of control if I would have reacted.
Yeah. Apparently, her mother, like so many black parents, we have to have that talk. We know that. Now, interesting to me, Bernarda, is the fact that the charges against Rosing, four counts of assault. But why is the charge against the officer, third degree assault, more severe than the charges stemming from what she did to Ms. Spring, who was actually involved in the incident?
So, Eboni, the crazy part about all of this is that she can get more time for assaulting the police officer than actually for assaulting Ms. Spring. That's the sad part about it. In the sense of the reason why the charge is much higher is because the police officer was hit in his police officer capacity. In every state here in the United States, when you hit a law enforcement officer or even an EMT or a fire marshal, people, because they're responding in their capacity, the penalties are much higher.
Okay, that actually does make a bit of sense now that you've explained it. Bernarda, let's turn to another campus incident, this one involving a white student suing a historically black college and university. Michael Newman, he's suing Howard University School of Law for racial discrimination. He cites pain and suffering, emotional anguish, and damage to his reputation. His suit seeks $2 million in damages. Now, he claims that between the fall semester of 2020 through September of 2022, that Howard Law created a hostile educational environment for him. At the center of the suit, it appears that there were statements made online by Newman that were deemed upsetting to the black students on campus, which all eventually leads to him being expelled from the school. We want to say that Howard's vice president and chief communications officer said in part that the university is prepared to vigorously defend itself in this lawsuit, as the claims provide a one-sided and self-serving narrative of the events. My goodness, Bernarda, surprisingly, Newman is suing Howard under the Civil Rights Act of 1964. Tell us what he's got to prove to win his case.
This just goes to show you that anybody can bring a civil suit. So just because somebody can file a lawsuit doesn't mean that they will be successful, meaning that they will win the civil lawsuit. So in terms of this civil lawsuit, it's going to go through various stages. One of the first stages is that our law school is going to file a motion for a summary judgment saying that you do not have grounds and you cannot show damage and you can't show a connection that it was at the hands of Howard University School of Law, whatever it is that you may have suffered. So I think for Howard University School of Law, a huge win would be the granting of that summary judgment. If that does not happen and the case continues, then it'll continue with the discovery process. And what's going to happen is that I'm sure both parties are going to be seeking to speak to other Caucasian students that may have attended the school and see whether there's a pattern of such conduct by either the school or to get character information as to the student who's actually former student that is suing Howard University. Yep.
Indeed. It's just rich, right? I think, you know, we've all matriculated on these law school campuses, so that one just took me for a loop. Now, I will say, Bernarda, the lawsuit that Newman has filed alleges that an administrator called him, quote, the most hated student at Howard, and that the students dubbed him the, quote, Mayo King and a White Panther. It's a lot. I don't even really want to spend a lot of time on those claims, but if indeed any of those claims are true, does that in and of itself prove Newman's case? Does that hurt Howard?
No, not at all. In terms of hurting Howard, of course it'll hurt Howard in terms of in the press, and that's for anyone that believes these actual claims. But still, we're talking about causation. Where's the causation from what was supposedly done? Because that's the first thing you have to prove. Then you also have to prove that it caused whatever damage that he so-called suffered. So before there is any kind of success in this case, you have to show the causation link and you have to show damage. So people can say anything. Remember, sticks and stones may break my bones, but words can never hurt me. Whatever happened to that line?
All right. So, counselor, you're going to stay with us because after the break, a man claims his lottery ticket was stolen, and we are going to see who gets the cash. Stay with us.